Okay, hello everyone and welcome back to Super Soka. We're once again on Kronos, the private vanilla World of Warcraft server, and we are Supa, level 9 Dwarf Priest. We're gonna do... Oh, wait, we have some quests pick up in town here? No. Okay. I know what those quests are, and they're not available for us, and we don't really need them. That's no problem. So, what we're gonna do today, we actually have two quests currently in our quest log, and it's pretty much all that's left. Last time... we traveled from Coldridge Valley up to Kronos. Actually, no, we were already in Kronos at the start of our play session. We pretty much wrapped up all the quests in Kronos, and some of them were over in Brunal Village. So we completed quite a lot in that area. Now we need to run up to Ironforge. We have a quest here called The Reports. We have to deliver to Senator Baron Redstone in Ironforge. And Senator Baron Redstone, if I remember correctly, is near... Yeah, there he is. He's in Ironforge in the chamber where King Magni holds court. So... we're going to see King Magni. He's the major kind of leader of the group there. So we're going to go and do that. And what else do we need to do? Well, we do have Shimmer Stout. So we have one more quest. It's way over here on the east side of the zone. I don't think we're going to go and do that quest just yet. We have some other things we can work on along the way. There's a couple sets of quests here. Not much, just a few quests. So it's really no reason for us to run all the way over there just yet. But we are coming up to Ironforge. You can see kind of this magnificent dwarven city built into the cliffside here. It's also got a little gnome quarter, so gnomes do take up a section of it, but it's mostly dwarves, I would say. We're at the gates of Ironforge. It's actually its own section within the world, so we actually get experience just for crossing the gates of Ironforge. It's kind of cool. Okay. So, getting closer, it's kind of a surprisingly long run. We're going to buff up Powered Fortitude while we're here. I always call it Powered Fort, but it's Powered Fortitude. If you don't know what that does, it gives you 3 stamina. 3 stamina translates into 30 health points. So we have 222 health, you can see in the top left. If we click this off, we have 192 health. So, 30 health for 3 stamina. Nothing too impressive. But it's better than nothing. Let's go ahead and buff up this little guy here, little gal here. Mimi Da, the Sea Kim, the 36 rogue, level 36 rogue. Some 60s running around here. Alright, but yeah, basically we want to make sure we go over there and grab that quest. I don't think, level 9, I think we grabbed our skills at level 8, so we don't have any skills to pick up here. We do want to grab the Flight Master while we're here. The Flight Master is over... kind of in the central part near the Great Forge, so we're gonna go see that too. If you've never seen old Iron Forge here, it's actually really cool looking, I think. We're kind of in the center of this big, I don't know, volcanic mountainside. See the lava in the middle. You can definitely die if you jump in lava. I mean, in fact, there's like no way up. I'm pretty sure you're gonna die 100% if you land in there. As far as I know, there's no way up. I don't try to explore that too much, if you understand what I'm saying. So here we are, the High Seat. This is King Magni Bronzebeard, right there. I think his brother is Bran Bronzebeard. He has a couple brothers, actually. I'm gonna turn in this quest. That was easy. Experience, some silver, nothing fancy. The whole point of that quest, at least I think, is simply to get you into Ironforge. So, easy enough. Let's see. Actually, I want to take one more quick look in this room. I thought there was some cool stuff in here, but I don't see it now. Yeah, I don't really see what I was looking for. I thought there was a door in here somewhere, but maybe not. Okay, let's go grab the flight point, and then I guess we're going to head back out to Dunmoreau, and we're going to work on a couple quests that we need to pick up out there still. Here's the Griffin Master off in the distance. You can see kind of a bugged out Griffin floating there. Some other people hanging out. I think the main capital city already gives you its flight point on this server. But, yeah, it looks like it. We don't have any connecting flights. You don't know any flights locations connected to this one. That's unfortunate, but not surprising, because we haven't been anywhere except for basically the starting area and Kronos. So, I'll probably fast forward a little bit here, but basically we're going to run out of Ironforge. I'm going the wrong way, I just realized. A little bit complicated route here. We're going to get out of Ironforge, and we're going to go through the gates of Ironforge to the front, and we're going to head east to these couple of quests here. I know at least 2 of them we can do on our own. There's a third one that we're gonna need to group up for because it involves killing like a level 12 elite, and we cannot solo level 12 elite at this point. But we'll grab the quests and we're going to look for the group while we complete the other two easier quests. And then once we... I'm trying to decide if we want to set our hearthstone here, because once we wrap up those quests, we'll probably... Actually, once we wrap those up, we'll just keep heading east, and we're going to head to a new zone today, hopefully, depending on how long these quests take us. My expectation is we will wrap up all three of these quests today, like I said, as long as we can find a group. And if we can't find a group, then we'll clear two of them. Whoops, wrong way. And we will just head out, I guess. We'll head out to the new zone. You know, we still haven't picked up our skills yet, our professions. We want to pick up first aid for sure. Even though not super useful, we're going to pick it up. Actually, to clarify, first aid, super useful for almost every class. I think it's less useful for healing classes. And since I'm planning on picking up tailoring and enchanting as my main professions, I don't want to use a lot of linen cloth and other cloth for bandages if I don't need to. If I can instead use that cloth for tailoring. So, it's going to be... I'm not sure exactly what I'll do. Probably won't skill up first aid rapidly. But okay, let's speed up the video. Got a couple minutes walk here. Nothing really interesting to report along the way, probably. And we'll slow it down again once we get to where we're going. Okay, we're coming up on... I don't actually know what this place is called. It's like a dig site or excavation site or something. Golbolar Quarry. Got it. And there's some... Oh, cooking trainer here. We might as well grab cooking. Took us about 2.5 minutes to run over here. Not that long, but... we haven't learned cooking yet, right? Let's go ahead and learn cooking. We can cook some stuff now. Do we have anything to cook yet? We do actually have some boar meat we can cook. Is this... Counts as cooking? Yeah, there's... Okay. We're gonna cook up some boar meat. The nice thing about cooking this type of stuff is it actually becomes worth more for vendors selling. Than if you just sell the raw ingredient, in most cases, I think. I don't know if that's 100% true, but most cases it's true. One thing I noticed that was really unfortunate, we actually can't talk in general chat until level 10. I'm pretty confident when I started on this server with this guy, you could talk at level 5 in general chat, but they nerfed it to level 10, which I understand. It's because they wanted to alleviate gold seller spam early on, as much as they could anyway. But that kind of sucks because we can't really easily find a group for things because of that. It's really annoying. So we need to kill Bone Snappers and Skull Thumpers. Okay. Skull Thumpers are out here, it looks like, for the most part. I don't see any Bone Snappers out here. Let's invite this guy to group, see if he wants to join. Normally I would... Hi. Working on killing Rock Jaws? Maybe? Let's find out. What other skills did I learn last time? Shadow Word Pain, Renew, Stone Form, nothing fancy. So we need to actually... Okay, we're gonna stick with this guy as best we can. We mostly just need to kill 6 of these. This is gonna be really easy to quest to kill. How did I one-shot a smite out aggro that paladin? Anyway. Yeah, it should be really easy to wrap up this quest. This is like one of the simplest quests in the game, I feel like, because you... have tons of mobs spawned, it seems. At least it seems like that. They're pretty low level relative to us. They're like even a level below us. It makes it easy. And they are right near the quest giver. The quest giver is like, here, kill these like rock jaws in this valley right next to me. And they're right there, so that makes it easy. Okay, what is this guy doing? Okay, got it. Yeah, so the real trick is going to be finding enough bone snappers. We need to kill 10 of them. I got a powered shield myself, I think. That'd make this a little bit easier. Ooh, I should renew on our buddy over there. What do I have renew set to? 5? Okay. Should be fine. I just want to kill this guy, get him off me before... Okay. Dead. Skull Thumpers. Almost done with Skull Thumpers. One more kill, that'd be it. Super easy. I'm just gonna melee this guy down. I wanna regen some mana. Easy. Cloth. We need lots of linen cloth. We're going to be tailoring and also consider getting first aid skilled up, which I don't know if we will, but we'll find out. Okay, there's... I feel like this paladin is, like, setting us up for failure somehow. He's, like, charging in here really fast, which is... Okay, but he's a little nervous about it. Our mana regen's not great either. Man. guys have an interrupt or something. They seem to knock us down, which is just annoying. Okay, there's this level 7 gnome warrior in here. That guy is maybe in a little over his head, I don't know. Okay, we don't really need skull thumpers. I mean, we do need one more, but we're gonna find some easily on the way out, so I'd rather just work and get our bone snappers out of the way. Let's blast this guy. What is Blessing of Might? It's a strength, right? Plus 20 melee attack power. Wow, so that actually basically is like... My melee attack power is 13 normally, and this bumps it up to 20? Or, sorry, to 33? That's awesome. Big upgrade. Too bad we don't... Oh my gosh. What was that? Anybody else see that? Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna... Throw it. If I can get out of here, I'll do something. Wow. I guess I disconnected? Okay. Did I just lag? Or is it the server? So, I haven't... Someone's lagging. Server lag? Or just me? I can't tell. Anyone else lag? It sort of seemed like everyone's lagging. Like they're just kind of doing weird things. But I'm not sure. Oh man, I was gonna follow that paladin, but it looks like he has the same problem. I'm gonna try and go back. It's a really bad spot to lag out. Let me check my... I run on Wi-Fi, by the way. Like, I mean, I have internet in my house. It's my own Wi-Fi. But let me just check my Wi-Fi and see what's going on. And try and load something else. Looks like my Wi-Fi is fine. So this must be a server issue right now. I'm guessing. Let's try... Hello? Looks like the server just died. Okay, so we're going to disconnect here. We're going to stop the video for the moment, and we'll be back once the server is back online. Okay, we're back in, but we are dying slowly. We spawned, obviously, in the middle of the cave, which is no good. I think we're going to be okay here if we don't keep getting stunned out of casting any damage spells. I think we're going to be fine. Jesus, this guy stuns like every... Every other hit that he resists that? I think we're gonna die. We do have a heal potion, okay. If I can just spam heals now, or spam damage, I mean, we might be able to win here. I don't know why this guy's doing so much to us, but he's just stunning us constantly. Okay, I don't want to aggro anything up here. Okay. Come on, Shadow Word Pain. Whew. Okay. Alright. We've established ourselves. Hold on one second. Okay, it was like a 5 to 10 minute disconnect there. Good news, we didn't die. Server's back up. And... Seems like, yeah, okay. Seems like we're okay. Bad news, we lost our buddy, and now we're stuck in the middle of a cave full of mobs that are fairly nasty. Because they stun, like, all the damn time. So we're gonna make sure we use our dots. I don't know if this powered shield does not do anything for keeping us from being stunned, unfortunately. We can clear these guys pretty well if we keep our... I don't get spam stunned. Stun spammed. Oh man, he had to resist that, really? Okay, I was worried he was gonna go aggro that group over there. Okay. I'm trying to fight my way out now, if you can't tell. It's my plan. Okay, I just wanted to safely loot that one. This is a skull thumper. We don't need a skull thumper. Unfortunately, there's two of these here. Skull Thumper and a Bone Snapper. Skull Thumpers are pretty easy because they don't stun. So let's see if we can draw this guy away from the rest without aggroing other stuff. Okay, we did aggro the other one. That's fine. I think we will leash him from about this distance. Maybe. Okay, there we go. Good. Here, run a powered shield. Great. So we're just going to clear him one by one. We did need one more Skull Thumper anyway, so this isn't so bad. However, mostly we're going to have to work with these Bone Snappers. And let's zap that guy. Okay. What's the mana cost on Smite? 30 mana. Shadow Word Pain is 25. So 30 damage over. For 25 mana, this is, okay, like 27 damage. Okay, so Shadow Word Pain is certainly more mana efficient, but it's slower. That's okay. We can tolerate slow. Right now, you need to mostly worry about mana, I think. Oh, there's a chest over there? Well, that chest is really deep in there, though, I think. Right? Oh, no, it's right there. Okay. Change of plans. We're gonna get that chest, guys. We're going to fight our way through this mess. We're going to get it. Looks like we're going to have to kill at least two mobs up on the kind of ahead of us to the left to get there. Maybe some more are over there. I'm not sure. But we're definitely going to fight our way in. We're going to go for it. All right, let's see if we can just... Oh, nice. We zapped that guy down pretty well. Okay. See, Hunter's Mark. Okay. Some people over there fighting. It's fine. Let's dot this guy. And I smite him. He doesn't stun us, which he's about to, I think. Okay, we're gonna shield up. Alright, just one more to clear, I think, over here. There's one more Bone Snapper, it looks like. Should be okay to sneak around these guys on the right. I think if we just hug the wall on the left, we can sneak around them. Okay, one more smite should get him to run away from us. Okay, great. Let's go ahead and eat and drink for a moment. I always have to kill one more before those guys come down here and snatch our chest. I think we can do that. They're not jerks about it. I think they've got a few mobs over here to deal with. Probably, possibly, maybe. Okay. So let's try to sneak. Oh no, crap. There's a third one there? Jeez. Okay, we definitely need to run. We're not going to take on three of these at once. And a respawn, it looks like, somewhere. Where did that fourth one come from? Okay, see, one on the left. Two on the left? Wow. There's a lot of mobs over there, guys. This is going to be a little tough. Okay, let's start with this one. Back up. Fight him from here. Really? That guy aggro on us? Actually, for real? Where'd he even come from? What is the aggro radius on that guy? Like, come on. Oh, and that one leashed too. Wow, that's stupid. Okay, we're gonna do this. Or we're gonna die trying. Let's pop a lesser heal. Okay, it doesn't seem like we aggroed that other one this time. For whatever reason. I have no idea how we aggroed... resist? I don't know how we aggroed that other one. It seemed like he was really far away. It seemed like he chased really late. Maybe he's a patrol... And he happened to just patrol in range the last moment there. I should have kept Power Word, Shadow Word Pain up on this guy. But I just didn't manage to do that in this case. Oh, Frostbit Staff. Can we use staves yet? We haven't trained staves yet. We gotta do that. How about this staff also? This Gnarled Short Staff. We can't train actually until level 10, so that's basically been why I haven't trained anything yet. Okay, we need two more Bone Snappers. We can get them easily on the way out, but I really want to try to get this chest. I think it's kind of fun just going for it. And we're close. We only need to kill three more mobs? Three more mobs? Yeah, okay. What are we going to do? We're going to come over here. Try to get in range of this guy. He's so far away. Can we just, like, go here? Okay. Hold that guy. Oh, aggroed that one also. That's not good. I'm gonna shoot this guy once to get a little more aggro on him. Put another dot on him. Make sure we stay aggroed. Okay, it should be far enough away. Okay, great. Great. Just tough to judge how far you have to run to leash a mob sometimes. And, you know, of course if you... Oh, gosh. Not again. Okay, we gotta do this. We gotta dot this one. We gotta run this way now to try and get a... Oh, not knockdown. Come on. And use our heal potion. Okay, that guy leashed. Great. Okay, I think now we're in the clear. We just need to zap this guy once with Smite. Should be enough to finish him. Okay. Whew. We'll use our heal potion. That's scary. Are we starting to get respawns or what's going on? Looks like maybe respawns. Okay, I think we can clear this guy without needing to take a break for healing up or mana up. As long as nothing spawns on us, we'll be okay. Really? Gosh, this aggro radius is so long. I feel like there's no way that we should be aggroing those guys. Okay, let's go here. Okay, we lost this guy too. Okay. Let's stabilize for a moment. I'm gonna go ahead and drink up. We don't have a lot of bread, so we can't eat a lot, but we can drink. Alright. I'm trying to position a little better. Maybe if we pull him to this side, it won't aggro that other guy. Yeah, that's better. Okay, I see where that guy... I didn't realize he was right behind that little rock there. Now we're in a better situation, I think. As long as... There's gonna be a respawn here soon. I can just feel it's coming up any moment now. And... It's gonna be a little ugly. Okay. A couple more smites and we'll have this guy taken care of. We don't get knocked down, spammed a bunch. I thought there should be, like, diminishing returns from... Even from PvE a little bit at some point, but it seems like none of this... has diminishing returns, which is fine, but just sort of surprising to me. Okay, we're gonna heal up, drink up, and we're gonna pull this guy next. Which I could have sworn we just pulled that mob, that was the mob we just killed, was that guy, but maybe something else spawned there? We might end up hearthing out of this place, by the way. It's a little inefficient to hearth out, but like, really? We're getting hit by so much junk here. Okay. Let's pull this guy. Let's back up a bit. Okay, I think we're good here. I don't think he'll leash, and I don't think we're gonna aggro anything else. Let's power word shield, keep our health up. It seems like we're going through our mana faster than our health when we power word shield, which is fine. I don't mind that so much. I just am mostly worried in case a respawn pops up. I want to have enough health to kind of sustain us against that. So to use our heal potion also. Okay, let's just dot this guy. One tick. Yeah, should be all it took. Okay, we're gonna drink up a little more. We're almost clear. I think we need to kill one or two more mobs on the left here. We just gotta go fast, because the problem is, if these guys start respawning, we've been clearing, then that kind of defeats the purpose. There is at least one mob over here, right? Two mobs, okay. So let's try this. Let's grab this guy, powered shield. Okay, we didn't aggro anything else. We get knocked down, of course. I'm wondering if we can just leave the mobs on the left alone and just kind of sneak along the right side now and get over there to get that chest. By the way, I'm like 90% sure this chest is going to have junk in it, but on the off chance we get something worthwhile, you know, it's kind of fun. And either way, I'm kind of excited just getting through this mess that is this cavern. Just going to melee this guy down. Maybe. Ooh. Okay. There's two there. I wonder if we can... What happens if we just step out here? Okay, we aggroed that guy. That's fine. Oh, we aggroed two. It's not good. Okay. Let's back up a little more. Really? That leashing... Come on, just leash. Come on. Whatever. These guys are fighting the good fight. And I'm gonna go grab my chest. I fought for this chest. I don't feel too bad about bailing on those guys, because... I've been fighting this chest really, really long. Oh, we're in combat. We can't loot a chest in combat. Alright, you guys got it. Do it. Finish it up. Kill that bone snapper, please. Leaving combat. Go, go, go. Grab the chest. Okay, what do we get? Healing potion. Pants. Light leather. Belt. Spring water. Run. Alright, least we can do is buff everyone up. So let's, toss some buffs. Toss some buffs. Oh, this guy's got him already buffed. Okay. And this warrior's already got a buff. Great. And we actually will get whatever is in this guy. Okay. Now we need to get out of here. We're probably just going to book it out of here as fast as we can. We're just going to maybe power shield and run out of here. How many mobs are up there? Not too many. I think we can just fight this guy. And then not risk dying running out of here. Now we fought for so hard for that stupid chest. Man. We survived through a disconnect and multiple aggro pulls of like extra stuff, and we survived, and we looks like we're gonna make it out alive. That's a victory for us. I'm gonna Ooh, Journeyman's Cloak. Nice, we got some armor, guys. We got a 7 armor back. Amazing. So that find a treasure worked well for us. Okay, are we gonna run shit out of here? I think we're gonna do it. Powered shield. Oh, this is a bad idea. I already regret this decision. Already regret this decision. Oh no. Can I heal potion? Can I forward shield? Yeah, I can, but still dead. Oh, that was a terrible decision. Okay, we're gonna run back. So, yeah. All right. We're just gonna fast forward the video for this run. It's a couple minutes run back. Okay, we're pretty much back. We're trying to grab our corpse from up out here. Yeah, this is perfect. Okay. So, that was a really dumb decision to run out of there like that. We ended up using our healing potion. We spent one to get to the chest. We got one out of the chest, and then we spent it right away trying to run out. So that was a wash. We definitely lost a little bit of gold due to ha our silver due to having to repair from that death. And we got a green out of it. Not sure that's that useful. Maybe a little useful. Okay, so we've completed all these quests now in this area. There's really nothing else here. The only quest remaining is protecting the herd. We can't solo it though, like I said. And we can't find a group very easily because we can't talk in general chat, so I can't even ask if anyone needs to do the group, do the quest. So, we're basically what I'm gonna do is go ahead and just grind out to level 10. We're gonna do that by walking kind of east of here, clearing a few mobs. You can see on the map, we're gonna head this direction. We're gonna clear some junk along the way. And what we're gonna go is turn in the Shimmer Stout quest also, because that'll give us some experience in turning in the quest, and hopefully along the way we'll grind out a couple mobs, and that'll be enough to secure us level 10. We can look for a group then for the quest. If we can't find a group, we're just gonna bail out on this zone. We're just gonna move along. If we can find a group, perfect. We will do that quest before we go. I think it has a nice reward. I can't remember what it is. I just remember thinking it has 3 rewards you choose from, and they're like, it's a good one for cloth wearers, good one for leather wearers, good one for mail wearers. So we want to do it if we can. Let's just whack that guy. Okay, great, good, down. Also, level 10, we're gonna get talents. So we can't. If you look down at the little menu button down here, we have our character info, spellbook and abilities, and the hotkey for these is C and P, and then N would bring up our talents, but we have no talents. Oh, I'll join. Looking for more, protecting the herd. Okay, let's head over there. Let's see. What do we have? A level 10? Level. Okay. Hi. Think we can duo? I think it might be tough for us to duo it. We might be able to. I think it's a little bit tough. Fight level 10 might be a little bit easier, because at least then we have some, What's that guy saying? The hell? It's like a Russian symbol, the first part, and then some like a comma B, my bad. Huh? MB means my bad, I think. That's like all I understand of what he just said. Okay, we just got 65 experience finding the Amberstell Ranch. That's where that quest is actually at. So that's kind of cool. Whoa, that Kragboar was fast. Did you guys see that? I'm thinking like boosted over here. Oh, is that guy? Okay, good. Bear's gonna aggro on that woman, Gienna, the human warrior. Drot just died. Okay, we should be able to trio this, no problem. Yeah, should be no problem. So I need to go grab the quest first. It's just over here at this ranch. I guess while we're waiting, we can kill this boar at least. What am I doing? Okay, there we go. Okay, we're gonna spam some smite on this guy. Okay, Drath. Okay, great. Drath's on the way. Chunk of boar meat. We're gonna cook up some boar meat later. We got the cooking that we picked up a little bit ago. I'm the United States of America. Yeah. Yep. Okay. Let's grab this. So let's look at the rewards. Oh yeah, there we go. Legs. 20 armor, 1 stamina, 1 spirit. By the way, I equipped this Journeyman's Cloak, 7 armor, We actually already had a goat fur cloak that had two more armor than that. That was my bad. I misjudged that. Definitely. For some reason, so I have this mod that will like show me what gear I currently have equipped, but sometimes it doesn't work properly and doesn't show anything. I don't know why. A little glitchy. But hi, who is this? Lion Ilya? Hi. Okay, I think we have, what do we have? A hunter, a mage, a warrior, and a healer. Okay, we can do an instance of this group. We just need to find an instance that's level appropriate. None of them exist. I am. Ragefire Chasm is the lowest level instance in vanilla. That is a level, I really feel like you need to be level 13 in that instance. Level 12 maybe you can push it, but really like 13 minimum makes it a little more reliable. Okay. Oh, I just remembered I need to change my channels and get rid of Whisper. I like to have a guild chat channel so I can catch up. Okay, hold on a sec. That guy's invite percent T. Who is that? Henkari? Okay, we're gonna toss on the buffs. Lego Legends of Chima, by the way. In case you think that is a guild from China, it is not. My understanding is that it is a normal guild. Like, normal, I guess, is kind of a weird word. Maybe an offensive word, I don't mean it in any negative context, but it's not like a gold farming guild if you had some suspicion. That's my understanding, anyway. Okay. Thanks. Will do. Alright, so where is our guy? Slow respawn on this thing. I remember this from in the past. It always seems like a really slow respawn. Just likes to take his time. He'll spawn like right where I'm standing, so I probably should get out of here. Yeah, for sure I should get out of here. He hasn't spawned yet anyway. Kind of slow respawn, I think. Can't see crap through these trees. There we go. I don't know if that Henkari guy is going to stick around. Henkari? But we'll easily get this quest done with a group this big. Ooh, thank you. That was a real fast buff. Super appreciated. Where's a little rogue buddy? There we go. Easy. I'll spam the heals. You guys, DPS, KK. Actually, I'll put a Shadow Word Pain on there too, but yeah. Just hang out here. Let's do some inspections. See, what does this person have? Camping knife. Small, man, they've got like 4-8 slots worth of gear. We have 6, so we're missing bracers and a belt. We still don't have a belt, which sounds crazy. What about our dwarf hunter friend here? Also 8 pieces of gear. Am I the only one that doesn't have a belt? Nope, that clothy doesn't have a belt. So that's something. And, okay, there we go. Dots. TNT, go. Good job, warrior. I want to select this guy. Give him a little buff. We can throw a smite onto him, I think. And then we're going to throw a heal onto this warrior. Keep the warrior alive. I almost let the warrior die there. That would have been no good. Would have been a little embarrassing, I think, letting a warrior die against his mob. That was really easy. Great. Thanks, all. Okay. Let's hope this lets us hit level 10 now. It'd be nice to be able to just talk to people. We'll see. Let's leave the party. Okay. We're going to jump down here and hopefully not take a lot of fall damage. A little bit of fall damage. Not so bad. Okay, let's turn in. Let's get our pants. Is this our first green item, I think? All right. Level 9. Cool. Oh, sorry. Level 10. What am I saying? Okay, first. We're going to get our pants on before I forget. 1 stamina, 1 spirit. Awesome. That... Rancher's Trousers. No, not our first green item. We got the Friar's Robes of Light from that priest quest a while ago. I also just realized I missed a water barrel up there, but that's okay. So now that we're level 10, are there more quests here? There is actually something here. But I don't know if I care. Like, I don't know if I want to go back there just for a quest that popped up. That's fine. There was already 2 quests there, and now it's a 3rd quest, but it's okay. Now, you know, our button didn't pop up. I noticed this glitch. I think it has to do with my mods, or my add-ons, that, basically, by breaking the bottom bar, they don't update properly. But when I relog, it'll be updated. So it'll be there. But we can still open it up by pressing N. So, what I was told is we need to spec. What is it? Spirit Tap and Wand Spec. to start. Increase your damage with wands by 5%. Like, apparently that will help you maintain... Is that a chest? Water barrel. Okay. That will help you maintain a lot of mana while you're leveling. You'll level more efficiently. You can spec shadow, and you'll do a lot of damage if you go heavy shadow spec, but apparently, like, there's some other spec that's a little bit better as far as your DPS will be lower, but your, like, experience per minute will be higher. Okay, so we're going to look at... I want to see what this is. Gives your shadow spells a chance. Okay. Spirit tap. Gives you a 20% chance to gain a 100% bonus to your spirit after killing a target that yields experience. For the duration, your mana will regenerate at a 50% rate while casting. Okay. So if we kill... We get this 5 points in this eventually. Every time we kill a mob that gives experience, we'll have double spirit and... we'll have double spirit for 15 seconds. And during the 15 seconds, during a combat, we will still regenerate... Oh no, during casting, we'll still regenerate 50% of our mana for 15 seconds. Okay, that seems really good. Wand spec also seems nice. We don't have a wand right now, so let's we'll fix that problem later. We're going to definitely max out spirit tap. I think that's the way to go. Food crate in the middle of the ocean. Let's go grab his food crate. We're low on food, so I'm going to grab some. I don't really need food. I mostly need drinks. I mean, this might have a drink in it, but solid food isn't as important to us since we can heal ourselves anyway, as long as we have mana. But I don't mind grabbing it anyway to get a little more food in our bags. Okay, well, it's water. That's even better, I think. It's like one water. It's not that great. Okay. Let's go turn in this barrel of stout. We've been holding on this forever. And I don't know exactly what this place is called up here. It's like kind of, So there is a quest here, the Lost Pilot, but I think we're going to not worry about that, because we want to get over to Loch Madon. It's over here. We zoom out, we can see Loch Madon is this big lake area, and we can cut through to Loch Madon from here, so I think we're going to go for that. We're also going to whack this rabbit on the way. Let's get him. There we go. Perfect. And where is our guy? Okay. They go through this passway here. South Gate Pass, that's what this is. Huh. What's going on in guild chat? Called Charlotte. Blah, blah, da, da, da. Don't know. Welcome to the guild. Maybe that's an alt. I don't know who that person is yet. Okay. Where's our turn-in guy? Is he like up this hill here? Off to... There he is, there he is. I knew he was nearby. I just didn't see him, and I was kind of wondering if our add-on was a little buggy. Alright, Earl of Shimmerstout, complete quest. Take the cask of Shimmerstout to Mountaineer Cadril. Follow the road straight into Thalsimar. Okay. Well, that's easy enough. He's going to send us along our way. And we could stop and kill some mobs along this path, but mostly... Ooh, stealth and... Our guild is just, like, exploding suddenly. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. An announcement from the GM. Well, welcome to the new person. And let's buff this guard, just in case some alliance scum. Oh, no, we didn't even buff the guard. I don't know why we can't. Oh, I know why. They're PvP flagged. There is one thing that, when people are PvP flagged, on it seems like this wasn't the case as I remember it on Vanilla WoW, but on these private servers, I notice if people are PvP flagged, I cannot buff them. Like, I cannot heal them or buff them unless I... I'm also PvP flagged. I guess it makes sense because it makes so you won't accidentally get PvP flagged if you don't want to, but it's not intuitive. Like, you won't notice that's going on until you really think about it, so it's a little annoying. Okay, there's another quest up here. A couple quests we can work on right now. And what? Let's see. Let's get in there and grab this quest first of all. Okay. Just want to get our quest picked up, and I want to run to Thalsimar. It's the city, the main alliance, the only city, I think. I don't think it's a horde city in Loch Madon. Well, actually, I know there's not a horde city in Loch Madon, at least not one with a flight point. I'm going to get over there and turn in some stuff. So, we have one quest to turn in there, but mostly I think I just want to go up there just so we can grab flight point. And I kind of want to fly back to Ironforge. Let's see, with 23 silver, I kind of want to fly back to Ironforge and learn... Enchanting, tailoring, first aid, and our level 10 skills. My concern is that we don't have enough money to do that. Actually, I'm pretty sure we can't, because I think it's 10 silver to learn a profession. Is it 10 or 1? If it's 1, we're fine. If it's 10, That's basically almost 90% of our money just to learn enchanting, tailoring, and we wouldn't even be able to learn first aid. We're not going to get a lot of benefit out of enchanting right now anyway, but let's head over there. We're still going to go over there and take a look at everything in Ironforge so we can at least get our level 10 skills. Very minimum. I think it's going to be useful, and I think we should also teach ourselves... Oh man, I know it's 10 silver per weapon that you learn. I kind of think we should learn how to use staves so we can at least, instead of doing 2.1 damage per second, we can deal, what is it, 5.7 damage per second. I feel like going from 2.1 to 5.7 is a pretty sizable upgrade for us. Oh, let's see if I can buff that guy out of range. My bad. Warrior, you'll get a buff at least. Alright, so, everyone, welcome to Thelsimar. I don't know if I'm saying it right. I think it's right. Thelsimar. Talk to the Griffin Rider. There's actually a cool quest here. I think it's here. Where you have to like fly back and forth from here to Ironforge anyway. So it's kind of nice if we grab this quest, we can just talk to the Flight Master here, fly over to Ironforge, complete the quest there, and fly back. Let's turn in our cask of stout. Was that stout? Yeah. Rat catching. Okay. Rat ears. We need some rat ears. Speak with Mountaineer Stormpike, okay? Where's Mountaineer Stormpike? Oh yeah, way up here, right? Yep. Okay, we will eventually find Mountaineer Stormpike. Not just yet, but soon. And then there's another quest in this little... This kind of reminds me of like The Hobbit, like these kind of underground burrows. Like, I don't know what you call them, burrows maybe? It's underground, semi-underground houses. Honor students. Bring Brock's list to whoever in Thelsimar, okay. That's easy enough. Okay. This guy is the Flight Master, so it's easy to find him. We're going to run back there and talk to him in just a moment. We're going to stop in the inn, and I think we will... I think we'll set our Hearthstone here. We can probably get a few levels out of this city. It's kind of weird. Lachmodan's strange, because I feel like you can quest here from like 10 to 12, maybe 13, and then you can't. I feel like there's quests that require you to be like 17 to finish in the zone. So, at that point, we're going to have to go somewhere else, and I have an idea where we'll head, but that'll be another couple play sessions. Okay, bear meat, boar meat, spider ichor. Got it. Alright, and now let's go turn in our quest over to this Flight Master. So we've got a bunch of quests here, and we can, honor student, that's easy, it's right here. Rat catching, blood sausages, we can do those easily. Defense of King's Land, we can do that one. A little bit tougher, but we can do it. Okay, complete quest. We got 200 experience and became honored with the Nomergon Exiles, okay? Accept. Ride to Ironforge, okay? We're gonna fly over to Ironforge. We're gonna speed up the video for this relatively short flight. Alright, here we are in Ironforge. We're back again. We need to turn in these quests over here at the top. And, you know, I kind of like the questing mod. I know it's maybe not as much fun because I'm looking at the map a little bit more often and kind of being guided around things. But at the same time, I feel like it's very... Basically, to be honest, I feel like when I'm narrating things, I tend to play a little bit slower because I'm trying to talk things through a little. And I try to find a little more entertaining routes to do things instead of just sitting there grinding on mobs. So to kind of compensate for that slightly slower leveling, I will use Questy. Okay. By the way, this quest, basically, you turn in the letter... It's all good. We get this, what do you just call it? Complimentary... Bring the honorary picks. That's what it is. Not complimentary. Honorary picks to blah 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 in Ironforge. This guy's back in the center here. And so I just kind of like it. Because I think it makes things a little bit easier. Obviously, it makes it easier. Clearly, it makes it easier. Actually, there's no question about that. But I like to use it. I don't think anyone that's watching has ever complained in comments below about this. So I think everyone's generally okay with Questy. We need to turn in this Grythurdin, complete quest, buy a Griffin ride back. Okay, we will do that, not just yet. We need to find our... Okay, here we go. Ironforge Guard. Class Trainer. Priest. Okay, looks like we're way up in the northwest, I think, right? The Mystic Ward. Okay. Okay, there's the Mystic Ward. We're along the way. Let's stop and try to find the enchanting and tailoring people. I'm hoping they're not... What's on your mind? Profession trainer. Tailoring. Tailoring's nearby. Okay, I'm gonna stop over there real quick. And profession chainer. Enchanting. Okay, also nearby. And I think first aid is also over there. Actually, I know where first aid is. So let's go first, train our skills level 10. That's the most important thing. We can wait on our professions. We don't want to wait if we have a nice upgrade on our skills. You can probably already tell that priest leveling is a little slow. Definitely slower than the warlock series I had going. Warlocks are like impressively fast. So it's definitely nice to not, you know, slack on getting our skill upgrades. I think we're going to regret that if we don't get those. And I'm also, I mentioned this already, I'm also leveling a warrior in my free time, like my non-narrated leveling series free time. And it's really fun, but it's also really slow, maybe slower than the priest. Desperate prayer, hold on, speak to High Priestess Lorena in Stormwind. Okay, it's a priest quest. Let's see what we get trained. Nothing in discipline, lesser heal, rank 3. Resurrection, oh, this is nice, okay. So now we can actually be useful and in a party and resurrect people. Brings a dead player back to life with 70 health and 135 mana. Not a lot of health, not a lot of mana, but we are going to grab that. Lesser heal, it's, I think the major heal we're going to use, Mind Blast. Blast the target for 39 to 43 shadow damage and causes a high amount of threat. Is that better to cast than Smite? 50 mana, let's say 41 damage. 50 mana, 41 damage, like 0.8 damage per mana. Smite is about 1 damage per mana. So it's not really more efficient, but it's higher DPS because it's faster. It's 25% faster. So certainly more DPS, but I don't know if that's a great thing altogether. Okay, we will... Do we have anything else on here? No. Okay, and Mind Blast. We will train it, but I just don't know if I'll use that a lot. I just don't know enough about it. If you guys know anything about that, if it's better to use that instead of Smite, let me know, but I'm pretty confident it's not better. Okay, but lesser heal, rank 3. Let's pop that up down there. And what else did we learn? Mind Blast, Resurrection, right. So let's just put this on... It's an out-of-combat ability, can't use it in combat, so we can just pop it on our F5 key, something we're not going to use a lot, hopefully. Maybe... Yeah, that's good. And... Mind Blast. I don't know. We'll throw it on there, but I'm not sure I'm going to use it. Grants immunity to bleed, poison, and disease effects. In addition, armor is increased by 10%. Why have I not been using that? I forgot about the armor increase part of it. Oh, wait. Hold on a sec. We're going the wrong way. Okay. So, I think I'm going to skip first aid if it costs 10 silver, and we're going to instead spend our 13 silver, the little bit we have left, and we're going to spend it on learning tailoring. Think. Maybe enchanting? I can't decide. Let's do tailoring. Okay. Where is Journeyman Tailor? How much does it cost to train me? 9 copper. Okay, not even 1 silver. Amazing. Beautiful. White linen shirt. Sure, we'll learn how to make that. Let's take a quick look at this. Tailoring. I've never, ever learned tailoring, so I don't know anything about it. Okay, we can make linen cloth. We need bleach, and we can buy these things from a guy here. Okay. Anything useful to us? No, nothing useful at the moment. Okay, that's fine. Good news is I'm pretty sure linen cloth is fairly inexpensive on the auction house. Maybe not. The Ankirosh war effort is going on, and that war effort does use linen cloth for some stuff. So that's a little possibly disappointing for us. Maybe it's pretty expensive. Ironforge physician is what we're looking for. This guy will teach us first aid, which we might not use a lot, but we'll find out. And man, wait, where's I walked right by enchanting. It's back there, isn't it? Let me go back up there. First, we'll talk to this first aid person before I forget. Train me 90 copper. That one costs a lot more. Huh. That costs a silver, practically, whereas the other one cost like 10 copper. Weird. I think this is the... Yeah, it's on the map, still a little mark here. I didn't really realize Arcanery. I guess it makes sense. Arcanery for enchanting. Enchanting supplies, journeyman, enchanter. Okay. Train me. Okay, that's cheap. Yes, that's our second skill. We'll learn it. Sounds good. We're going to make a lesser magic wand for ourselves someday. Okay, enchanting. Let's take a quick look at this. Okay, ruined copper rod. Okay, so that's like our tool. We need one of these. Strange Dust, Lesser Magic Essence, Copper Rod. Then we can start enchanting plus 5 health. And what is this? The defense on a... What does this go to? Permanent Hand of Bracers. Got it. Okay. Enchanting supplies. Is there anything... Oh, so we can... Hold on a sec. Let me make sure I got this. Enchanting. We need a ruined copper rod. So we need to buy a copper rod, then get this stuff and cast it. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. So copper rod costs 1 silver, 11 copper. We can buy strange dust and lesser magic essence. We're not going to do that. We're definitely not going to do that. Let's sell a few things. Okay, junk. 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 We're going to keep this to disenchant. We're going to sell this crappy staff. This is the worst of the two. Yeah. Honorary picks, we're going to keep. Roasted boar meat, we can sell. What is this? Light leather. We're just going to vendor that. Yeah, we'll just vendor that. Okay. Cool. I think that's good. Well, one final task. Can we use wands right now? Skills? Weapon skills, wands, unarmed maces. So we can use maces and wands. That's all we can use right now. Alright, we're gonna go to the military ward. Last thing we're gonna do real fast. And we're gonna buy... We have 13 silver. You can buy one skill. I don't know what that skill's gonna be. I think staves would be a good idea. I think it'd be a great idea. Then we can equip our staff, we can sell our crappy little mace, and we will be in business. So, there it is, Timberline Arms. I'm pretty sure this is the place that'll teach us how to learn other weapons or whatever. Timberline Arms. Weapon Master, okay, train me. Wait, really? There's nothing? Where do we go to learn weapons? Weapon Master? Does this one teach us anything? Daggers, okay, that's cool, but... Let's repair. Where do we learn... Where can I train two-hand staves? Stormwind? Daggers would be good, but we don't have a dagger right now. So, I don't think it's necessary. Okay, well, yeah, I think it's Stormwind. It must be... Not Ironforge, so must be... Okay, well, we're going to stop here for today. So, let's recap real quick. We started off in Dunmoreau and Kronos. We ran to Ironforge the first time. Did a couple quests over... What is this? Bear meat? Okay, we did a couple quests here in the eastern side of Dunmoreau. Crossed over to Lochmadon. Went to Thelsimar. Turned in some quests. And now we're back in Ironforge. Tomorrow, or the next time anyway, we're going to go to Stormwind. And we're going to do that so we can... What do we want to do? We want to work on this priest quest and train staves. So that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time.